you're feeling lonely today, come along and throw your cares away.
Raw was built on a six-man tag dream match, and we got it. And thanks to Big E's anger, we then got another dream match, a triple threat match between Big E, Lashley, and Roman Reigns as the main event. Wow, amazing Raw. But this is things you might have missed. But before we get started, make sure you've hit the like button on the video. It really helps these videos out. And if you are new to the channel, hit the subscribe button. I'd love you to do it. Paul Heyman literally gave me the ammo for this one. Please, just listen. Raw this week started off with the New Day, and of course Big E, being the new WWE champion, had some words to say, including a tribute to Brodie Lee.
I'm grateful for all of you below the heavens and one incredible friend above.
But it didn't take long for Roman Reigns to come down and confront Big E and the New Day. And of course, this was cool. The pop that this got was huge. The six-man tag kicked off Raw until Bobby Lashley literally came to the ring and destroyed everybody. Of course, that meant that Roman Reigns would then pull double duty as we got that triple threat main event with spots galore. It was such a good match. There was a great moment, though, where Big E splashed Roman and Lashley. Usually, after pinning Lashley, the person would go over to Roman and try and pin him. The fact that WWE didn't do that deserves credit, because it doesn't make Big E look desperate. And that is genius, because it's such a rehearsed spot that we see it all the time. So kudos to WWE for not doing that. It was then Lashley using a steel chair on Big E that allowed the tribal chief Roman Reigns to spear Lashley and get the pinfall. Do you notice though, Roman's wearing a red glove on Raw. That was kind of cool, I like that. But I'm hoping that Big E and Lashley, the fact Lashley used the chair, is a setup for some kind of Extreme Rules match between the two, because Extreme Rules really need some extreme matches. Giant Lily returned on Raw this week as Alexa Bliss had an Alexa's Playground in the ring on Raw. That was kind of cool, with Charlotte Flair being the special guest. And this promo went everywhere.
Oh, let's not talk about originality, please. Okay.
Obviously referencing the critics of Alexa Bliss that would say that Alexa Bliss stole Bray Wyatt's gimmick, copied Bray Wyatt's gimmick. And you know what? This is promo gold. If you love Alexa Bliss, you're behind Alexa Bliss. If you don't like Alexa Bliss, you might be behind Charlotte right now, especially after she grabbed the Charly doll and literally ripped Charlie's head off. Again, Charlotte, do you not watch Toy Story? You can't do this to toys. But of course, it's when she went to do it to Lily that Alexa Bliss completely snapped. I love this. This was so good. The promo between the both of them was great. The crowd were into it. And I'm so looking forward to Extreme Rules. I'm really hoping Alexa Bliss gets the win. I feel like the character deserves it. The fact she's selling merchandise, which, talking of merchandise, she literally has new merchandise out with a new Lily doll shirt. Trick or Treat, obviously Halloween inspired. It does look really cool, let's not lie. That is going to be bought by a lot of people, I can guarantee it. Are we getting the old Shayna Baszler back? Literally this week on Raw, she took on Nia Jax. Nia Jax started off almost bullying Shayna, and Shayna just snapped. Shayna was kicking and punching away at Nia until she got that choke on Nia and literally won the match. But it didn't stop there. She put Nia's hand in the stairs and, well... And if that wasn't enough, she didn't even end it there. A lot of credit here has to be given to Nia Jax for that amazing selling. The screams were great. But Shayna Baszler almost being torn about doing this. She was still friends with Nia. But she had to snap. She had to lose it. She has to go back to the Shayna Baszler she once was. and kick some effing ass. And that's exactly what she did tonight. Hopefully this continues. We also found out on Raw something about Riddle. Not just the fact he synced up his and Randy's playlist on Spotify, but...
like, what would my spirit animal be? Maybe I'm a mongoose.
That's right. Riddle is a mongoose. Honestly, what are things sometimes I say on YouTube that I never thought I'd ever say? We had the creation of a new tag team this week. Humberto Carrillo and Angel Garza, of course, real life cousins. Seemingly, both of them WWE haven't had any plans for. And you know what? As a tag team, they were really good. I was really into their match. And you know what? There was some amazing selling here by Mustafa Ali as well. Play it.
Posits Carrillo into the barricade.
Goodness gracious!
Even though he wasn't on this week's Raw, there was a promo for Karrion Kross. Really good promo, and I'm hoping it's leading to something. We all know the booking for Karrion Kross has not been good at all, and these kind of promos are really starting to get him over. They're really starting to take an intrigue, and if it's leading to something, maybe potentially Scarlett joining him on the main roster, I'm all for it. Hopefully we see that sooner rather than later. There was a moment on Raw where Nikki A.S.H. and Rhea Ripley came out and basically announced about WWE's partnership with Conor Secure. And a lot of Twitter really ripped into Rhea for forgetting her lines. I honestly don't think she did. I think emotion took over. I think this really touched Rhea Ripley. And do you know what? We see this badass Rhea Ripley all the time. And to see the real Rhea Ripley like that was... amazing. So much respect for someone that can have that much emotion and still try to remain somewhat in character. Really, really cool. And well done to Nikki A.S.H. for helping Rhea through that as well. The two did go on tonight to win the Women's Tag Team Championships. You know what? It was a feel-good, great moment. The two were happy. The crowd popped. The crowd were really into it. So that's a win. And hey, it's giving them something new to do. And hopefully... breathes a bit of new life into that women's tag team division. Doudrop again faced off against Eva Marie, defeating Eva Marie. But a lot of people are talking about the fact she did this pose again after the match. This is Alexa Bliss's pose. Put the play and pain gloves on. That is her pose. Very interesting that she keeps doing it, isn't it? WWE definitely usually don't do things the same for the same people on the same brand like this. So... very surprising they're allowing her to do this if it's not related to Alexa Bliss. Honestly, this was cool. Xavier Woods nearly pinned Roman Reigns tonight on Raw. That would have been amazing, man. Honestly, it felt like it was about to happen too. Sheamus literally busted his nose wide open in his match against Jeff Hardy again this week. And Jeff Hardy was victorious. He will be in the United States triple threat match now at Extreme Rules. But did you know at a live show over the weekend, Jeff Hardy actually rocked some old school gear. This was really cool. This is old school Jeff Hardy, the face paints on, the tank tops on, really cool. And tonight, it was like classic Hardy Boys Jeff Hardy. Really cool to see Jeff Hardy using this old attires. I really like that a lot. Really, really cool. And also from this match, let's just be thankful they put that Sheamus graphic there because, let's not lie, it does look like he's naked, doesn't it? Sheamus, come on, dude, stop doing this. We all know the WWE draft is coming up very, very soon. And it's not a surprise that WWE has started to use talents like Humberto Carrillo, like Angel Garza. And it's really good that they are because the draft should bring change to WWE. That's what they're promoting it as. It's what they've always wanted it to do. So really hope that this is a new start for a lot of these superstars. WWE is definitely, without a doubt, up in their game. Only like a few months ago, Raw wasn't great at all. Now we're getting matches like we got tonight with Roman and Lashley and Big E. And it feels big. And that's exactly what Raw should be. So props to WWE for starting to turn things around. Using Jeff Hardy seemingly the right way at the moment is good. Really looking forward to that match now at Extreme Rules. They've changed it from just being a basic rematch. So that's cool. I'm really getting behind WWE booking now. As long as they keep it up long term, this is exactly what their company needs. Overall tonight, I think Raw was great. I think it was easily 9.25 out of 10. Don't really want to go too much higher because that's like a debut and a return. We didn't get any of that. So I think the matches were solid. I think the card was good. Set up for Extreme Rules perfectly. So I'm happy. Let me know your thoughts in the comment section down below. Like the video, share the video. And if you are new to the channel, hit that subscribe button. I'll see you next time. Peace!